Mad God is such a badass name for a movie, directed by Phil Tippett. And as always, slight spoilers, but not the ending. And it's available on Shudder. And hey, man, let's see if this movie's good or not, man. So let's talk about it. So this movie was a pet project of Phil Tippett's, starting back in the 1980s, dude. Just chipped away at it throughout the years while working visual effects on classics like RoboCop, Starship Troopers, and even Jurassic Park. He damn near stopped working on Mad God when he saw how special effects had advanced throughout the years. But he said, hell no, I'm going to keep on doing. He kept on trucking, dude. Anyhow, so I'm just going to say this. This one's kind of hard to explain what the hell's going on. So I'm going to read the premise just to give you a little backstory on what's going on and give you my overall thoughts on the movie. Anyhow, here goes the premise. A corroded diving bell descends amidst a ruined city, and the assassin emerges from it to explore a labyrinth of bizarre landscapes inhabited by freakish denizens. Anyhow, let's talk about the good stuff first. I love the stop animation style mixed with live action. The world Tippett created, dude, is bizarre, strange, crazy, disgusting, fucked up, all the above, dude, seriously. And the world is indeed a nightmare. You know, it's crazy because once I started watching it, it was hard to stop because just the variety of creatures and characters presented, and there's just so much going on at once, dude. It's like, there's no wasted motion in this film at all. I mean, just odd things happen, like these drones or slaves, I guess, who are the most expendable things I've ever seen in my life, dude, because they could be working on a job or even finishing a job, and they're killed instantly, dude. It's crazy. You see a creature wrapped up in bandages that has, like, monkey sounds and shit, dude, with no legs, crawling around for food. Big-ass one-eyed monsters leading as the slave masters, randomly killing these drones I was just talking about earlier. And just to give a few examples about that. Anyhow, though, the main character looks pretty cool, though, I gotta say, in its uniform. Wears, like, a hat and a mask with a large, dirty trench coat. Anyways, though the world is dark and gloomy, it was well done, dude. And kudos to Tippett for creating a movie that took this long. Nearly 30 years. It's to be commended, dude, because that's a long-ass time to be working on a film. Now let's talk a little bit about the bad. While I understood what was going on during, like, the first act, things kind of went off the rails during, like, the middle part of the second act. And the third act, dude, I had a hard time just figuring out what the hell was going on anyways. Though I still enjoyed the visuals, I just couldn't follow the story towards the end. I started kind of falling out of interest, to be honest with you. I know there's some metaphor I couldn't understand with some deep meaning, but I just couldn't get it. Maybe I missed something. But anyways, though, I'll say this. It's entertaining for a one watch, but I don't think I'll ever watch it again, though. But I'll still recommend it. But like me, I'm sure all of you will be mesmerized with the visuals. Good luck trying to figure out what the hell the story is all about. Especially with the ending, dude. I have no clue what the ending means. But it's still a decent movie. A good one to watch, like I said. That's Shay Nasty's review. Not much else to really say about this one. So that's all for today, folks. Stay nasty, my friends. Be sure to stab through that like button to get to the subscribe one. Because on a Don't Split Up channel, hell has never been so cool. Shay Nasty out.
I'll see you soon.
Would you steal a car?
No.
Would you steal a computer?
No.
Would you steal a purse?
No.
Would you steal a TV?
No.
Have you subscribed to the Don't Split Up channel yet?
No.
Viewing without subscribing is a dick move.
Don't be a dick.
Subscribe. Click and subscribe. It's free.